What's up, guys? I'm J-Man, and let's talk about a favorite from the 90s, The Fifth Element. Released back in 1997, the film was a passion project for writer-director Luc Besson. It launched Mila Jovovich's career and has been a cult favorite for years. Now, every character in the movie has a significant role to play. Leeloo is the title character who is the key to saving the world. Corbin is the action hero who protects her. Cornelius is the knowledgeable person who basically leads the plot. Hell, even Ruby Rod, while basically being the movie's Jar Jar, is in charge of the contest that leads them to the elemental stones. Every character has an important role to play. Except for one. David's character. I mean, think about it. What exactly did he do? Give Leeloo some clothes to wear? Unlock and illuminate the secret cave? Find out info on Floston? Couldn't any of them have done any of that? He's not even really much of a character, he's just a wimpy joke who occasionally gives exposition to keep the plot moving. And then he's gone for most of the movie anyway. Don't get me wrong, I like the movie just fine the way it is, this is just my little rewrite and how I think it could have been a little improved. So, bear with me. In the movie, there's a love story between Corbin and Leeloo. His wife left with his lawyer years ago, and since then he's been picky about loving someone else, saying that he just wants to find the perfect one. And he ultimately finds it in Leeloo. Not because he finds her perfect, but because she's literally meant to be the perfect being. So what if the story was actually like this? Maybe it's not Corbin and Leeloo who fall in love, but rather Leeloo and David. Don't get me wrong, Corbin and Leeloo still have a relationship of a sort, but for them it's more of a father-daughter relationship. Partly because Bruce Willis is already 20 years her senior, but also because in the story, she reminds him of a daughter that he lost. You see, back when he was in the Federation Army, he had a daughter who was also enlisted. They were obviously very close, but maybe she died in battle, and he blames himself for not keeping her safe, and he's had to carry that burden for years. Then suddenly Leeloo crashes into his cab, and instead of being smitten, he's actually taken by her innocence. They still have that playful bada-boom conversation, and he chuckles at how naive and young she seems. After the whole police chase, he takes her to Cornelius. Once Cornelius discovers that she is indeed the Fifth Element, he faints as usual in the film. However, David then wakes him up, saying that a man came carrying this girl on the couch and he had to go immediately to deliver his cab to a man named Finger, something about a 6-month overhaul. Cornelius suddenly gets up and sees Leeloo resting on the couch. He explains to David that she is indeed the prophesied Fifth Element. David looks at her adoringly, as if he didn't expect it to be a girl. A girl who is so beautiful. He tells him to gently wake her while he goes to get something appropriate to wear and looks for the key to the temple. This is the moment where David tries to wake her up but decides to discreetly kiss her while his mentor is not looking. Leeloo wakes up, less than charmed. Maybe she grabs him by the face and shoves him off. He profusely apologizes and basically acts like a shy little boy who just got caught doing something bad. He confesses that he greatly admires her and how much of an honor it is to actually meet her. My name is David. What's yours?
Liluminae lecatariba lamina chai akbatasibat.
That's quite a mouthful. Is there a way to shorten that? A nickname, perhaps? He gestures with his hands how to shorten it. She thinks for a moment.
Leeloo.
David smiles. He gives a courteous bow to her, and she begins to let her guard down. There's a bit of a spark between them, as she can't help but crack a smile too. Back in Corbin's apartment, when Leeloo and Cornelius try to rob him of his tickets for Floston, he hides them away from the authorities, as usual. After he brings her out of the shower, she's all wet from the auto wash. He dries her with a towel, and instead of this being a tender romantic moment, he holds her like a child. It's weird. You remind me so much of her. See, I had this daughter who was in the army like me. We were in battle. I left her to fight on her own. She didn't make it. I blame myself for it ever since. And with you, it's like she's come back to life in a whole other form. I know you probably can't understand me, and it doesn't make any sense anyway. Afterwards, Cornelius knocks him unconscious, and he agrees to take the mission of escorting her to Flosston. At the airport, after Corbin manages to get on the plane with Leeloo and shoos David away, he tells it to Cornelius, and Cornelius says, "You must get on that plane. You must make sure that she retrieves those stones. I will go to the temple myself and make preparations. Good luck, my son." David stands with a very nervous look on his face. He sneaks onto the plane and eventually gets caught like Cornelius was. After Corbin fights off the Mangalores at the opera, he saves David's life from being a hostage. Then they proceed to look for Leeloo, who is still lying weak in the vent. Corbin brings her down, and David stands in the doorway, watching them. He's glad that she's okay, but also can't help but feel a little inadequate because of Corbin. Soon, he and Ruby discover the bomb, and they all run for their lives off the ship. On their way to Egypt, Corbin pilots the ship while David tends to Leeloo's wounds. Leeloo stares at him. What?
Humans act so strange.
Why is that?
Everything you created is built to destroy.
Yes. It's part of our nature, I'm afraid. Have you learned about that yet?
I'm not finished. I'm up to V.
V is good. There are good words in V.
Like what?
Valiant, vulnerable, very beautiful. A moved smile comes on Leeloo's face, and they hold a loving stare. At the temple, Corbin and Cornelius set up and activate the stones. David holds Leeloo and helps her to prepare for the coming doom. Leeloo, however, is disheartened after learning of war on her screen. Leeloo, I know there are some horrifying things in this world, things that make you question whether we deserve you, but I promise, there are some good things that are worth saving, beautiful things.
Like love?
Yes, yes, love is very good.
I don't know love. I was built to protect, not to love. There's no use for me other than this.
That's not true, David says. He continues with a trembling voice. I need you. I need you very much.
Why?
David struggles. He wants to tell her so bad, but he can't. He's really nervous because he feels like he has to choose between his faith and his feelings.
Why do you need me?
Leeloo asks desperately. David still struggles. He wants to confess his feelings so bad, but something won't let him. David, Cornelius says, it's all right. You can tell her. David looks into her pleading eyes. Because I love you, Leeloo. Because I love you. A tear falls from her eye.
You have permission. Kiss me now.
They hold each other in a passionate embrace. The stones activate, and Leeloo stops evil from destroying the earth. So that was my little rewrite on the fifth element. What do you guys think? How would you fix David's character? Whatever it is, don't be shy, leave a reply. Also, be sure to follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and please support me on Patreon. All links are down below in the description. And if you like this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the J-Man. Keep looking deep.